Okay, we are set up and ready to do the slitting saw cutting. First thing that I'm gonna do, I'm gonna get a touch of the piece so I can get a zero. So let's do that. Soaking for 45 millimeters, and the lead screw of our drill has a 6 millimeter pitch, so it is 6 millimeters per turn. Okay, here we go. I have some fluid coolant running, as you can see, and the RPM is as low as 50 RPM and the feed is 25 millimeters per minute. I'm gonna take it easy. Maybe I'll do the other side a little bit faster if this one goes well. Okay, let's go. Doing very well. Again, I'm going just a little bit too far. I'm also gonna have to go a little bit too far to clear this spot. And if necessary, I'm just gonna fill that excess box with the air. Maybe as the cut is progressing, I can show you what I'm gonna do next. these pieces 10 millimeter steel. And I'm going to weld these like this to these two and also to the other one. And these pieces I'm going to weld like I need. Switch to the other side. Okay, I have a problem now. I am at the end of my white travel, which means that I'm gonna have to move my column inside a little bit. And I decided I'm not gonna show you the other side because it's exactly like this side and it's more difficult to film. But I can show you what the clean, what the ready cut looks like. But I figured I'm gonna show you how I found level for the cut that I made with my bandsaw. I made like this. I put my caliper in this way against the table surface. And now I measure to the cut, and then I do the same thing with the other side and keep going until the distance between the cut and the table is just the same. It's that simple when great accuracy is not needed. Okay, let me move the column and do the cut. Okay, we got a clean cut. Pretty much what I was looking for. Okay. The next step will be drilling the holes, which you already saw a glimpse in my last video, but now you're gonna see a little more about it. Just a minute.